Not knowing how to scale up is one of the main reasons why most new and small businesses fail. A business is like a living thing. Anything that does not grow or evolve dies. Scaling up is therefore a critical phase in the life cycle of any business. Expanding a business while maintaining your core business philosophy is, however, harder than most people realize. It's called scaling up because it requires tactful and careful balancing of various elements of your business. As such, it is a science requiring expert knowledge. Starting a business is one thing, but maintaining it is another. Just like any other relationship, the honeymoon phase between the entrepreneur and the business eventually comes to an end, and the business owner needs to start dealing with the bitter elements of the business. As an entrepreneur, you may get into business because you have an innovative idea which you are passionate about, but you must understand that the product itself is a tiny part of your concerns. As a founder, you need to make sure that marketing is done right, human resources, compliance, etc. That is why entrepreneurship is not for everyone. You need to have the heart for it. It is easier to work and wait for a paycheck at the end of the month than to worry about paying 500 people while sales are dropping. While it is demanding, it is more rewarding for those who have the natural traits to handle it. I honestly believe that entrepreneurship should be a subject in schools and be offered to business-minded folk. Success in any sphere follows and is based on specific universal principles. In other words, business success is a science and is mathematical. If you obey certain principles, your business will without a doubt succeed. Unfortunately, most entrepreneurs treat businesses like gambling. They do whatever they can and hope for the best, leaving things to chance. You can't, however, really blame them because they just don't have the right knowledge. The subject called business economics in schools does not address the intricacies of starting and running a successful business. You know what else needs to be taught in primary and secondary school? How money works, that is, assets versus liabilities, the dangers of reckless credit conduct, etc. Almost 50% of credit active South Africans are drowning in debt. Why is this? Because the basics of money management are not taught at grassroots level. Most people learn these things the hard way when they find themselves shackled by debt and living from hand to mouth. Most businesses also fail simply because money is mismanaged.